And we're back! And this is ridiculous! What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing some more Ark Scorched Earth on the Poping Evolved Scorched Earth server. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a great day. Then we're back doing stuff and things. Thanks so much for coming to hang out with me. Make sure if you like what you see today, don't forget, smash the thumbs up button to show your support, peeps. And if you're new and you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe as well. So today I'm thinking, I was over at the base and I was doing stuff and things. And a couple of times in the last couple of times that I've been playing around here, I've really needed a lot of metal. Now there's no like volcano here on Scorched Earth. And honestly, metal is pretty scarce, except for if you come over to this area here. So let me show you on the map where we are. We're right over by this side here, kind of on the northeast side of the map-ish. And over in this area, there's tons of oil wells, the oil veins. This is where we set up our oil well right over here. There's tons of metal too, huge amounts of it, to be honest with you, compared to anywhere else on the map. I mean, you can see there's just like there's a metal node there, there's a metal node there, there's a metal node. There's like metal all over the place over here. There's tons and tons and tons of it. And so I was thinking we need to set up like a little metal refinery place, because, you know, when you harvest metal, and you refine it, I mean, the halves in weight. It's so much easier to just refine your metal in an area where the metal is and then bring your metal back to your base. And then also, this would be great because it would be an area that the community could use as well. I'm be honest with you, I'm not really sure if any of the guys have one of these set up already, but I'm thinking this is a really good spot. Right here, above where we have the oil well, there's this nice little flat area. And the cool part about this is that there's like no way for... There are some spawns that were up there, but once we build up there won't be any spawns. There's not really a way for anything to get up here. The little refinery that we're going to build wouldn't have any sort of a problem with, you know what I mean, there being like bad hombres in the area. So that's what I'm thinking we're going to do today. We're going to have to go ahead and do a little bit of building and do a building of the refinery. Now, we have a lot of materials that we need right over here, but we're going to have to set up like everything, man. I mean, we need to get, you know what I mean, a smithy and mortar and pestles, and we need to set up a little mini base over here if this is what we're going to do. Thankfully, we've got wood, we've got stone, we can get sand, we can get all the things that we need over here. I don't know. Jeez, I'm trying to think if I should bring somebody over. You know what? I probably should bring Fat Bug over here to help us with the harvesting of the stuff and things, just so that we have something. Maybe the Rock Elemental would be good too. I don't know if I want to walk him all the way over here. That would probably take a really long time. So anyway, it is what we are doing. I'm kind of excited about it. Like, it's one of those things where it's like, I don't know. I'd rather go out and like make like a thorny army or something. Like, I'd rather do a lot of taming and stuff and things like that. But we really need to get this done, man. And it's going to be such a help, like I was saying, for us and for the community. So let me go ahead and see about this. And then hopefully we don't die while we're here. I'm saying, I mean, it's dangerous. It's going to be dangerous. It's going to be storms. Oh, thankfully I got my Jerboa little buddy 75, I think. I'm not sure where we're up to yet. But yeah, so that's what I think we're going to get done today. Let me go ahead and get a little bit of the crafting stuff and things done. I could probably actually, to be honest with you, get some things done at the base. So we're good to go. But the biggest thing also is going to be refining all the metal we need in order to get, because what we're going to end up building is we're going to build the industrial forge, which is like a super unbelievably expensive thing to build. It's really, really expensive. I have a little bit of metal back at the base, but I mean, it's going to be crazy. So it'll be nice because when we're out there, we'll have a lot of metal. We'll have to build some refining forges in order to get it, but it will be good. And then we will have a thing and it will be unbelievable and amazing. Oh, you know what I'm saying right over here? You know what I'm saying right over here? Oh, I'm seeing a super awesome Lymantria. Oh gosh, look at that thing, man. I bet it's like level 1. What level are you? 4. It's the lowest level that you can get, but it's so beautiful, man. Those fire wings. Oh my gosh. All right, so let me go ahead and pop over here real quick. Oh, an adobe door blueprint. Amazing drop. All right, so like I was saying, let's go ahead and get started. Ugh, can't see. Let me head back to the base here, get some of the materials that we're gonna need. How much weight do we even have on this guy? Well, we got 700. We can bring some stuff and things around with this guy. So I'm gonna go ahead and get some of the stuff and things that we're gonna need in order to get the refining forge area stuff and things built. Industrial forge area stuff and things built. And I will BRBs, peeps. And we're back with the beginnings is ores of our little forge area, ready to rock and roll here. Hold on. Let's land like so. All right, sweet. So we just got this little area here. This is all we're going to do. We're really not going to make this amazing. Well, I want to make it like kind of cool. Like I'm going to do some stuff and things to it, but not like amazing stuff and things. Just like halfway amazing stuff and things. But over here is where we're going to put the industrial forge. We've already got our smithy. We've got some of these mortar pestles. We got some storage. We got a bunch of refining forges ready to get a bunch of other metal going. But also, I went ahead and built a fabricator. Let's go ahead and take a look at placing this bad boy over here. Like so, a little to the right, a little to the right, and a little to the left. Nailed the days that can't be stopped. We've got a fabricator too. So all sorts of stuff and things going on over here. Now, let me go ahead and squirt this inside of here. I've brought out our chainsaw, some different stuff and things. I was thinking about bringing out Fat Bug or something like that. But in this area, really, if I wanted to do that, I'd have to build a ramp. And I might. I might end up doing that. I don't know. I don't think, like, if you had an Anki, because of how spread out the metal is, I don't think that if you had an Anki, it would really be a super effective way to harvest all this stuff. I do have a couple of extra... Let's go ahead and land down over here real quick. Let me see if I can make a U-turn here so we can take out the scorpion. Oh, yeah. Nailed it. It keeps... Oops. And breath is done. It is safe to dismount. All right, so I had a couple extra oil refineries, or are they even called refineries? What are they even called? Oil pumps. So I placed a couple of those around here. I have another one in my inventory that I just got from a drop. So there's a couple oil pumps over here now. Anywhere that I see one up here, I'm just going to place some of these extra oil pumps that I have. And also, the closest water well is like down over in this area, I think. How much water do we have? We're about halfway full, and I just placed the water well over here. So if we do need water, the closest place that I can see that I think for a water well is, there it is, right there. So I'm pretty sure this is as close as it gets. So if we pop down here like so, and then looks pretty safe, and then let's see how much water's in here. Oh, it's already got almost 1,000. Holy crap, man, that's awesome. So there we go, like so. All right, sweet. So we can come get water over here if we need it. So what I got to do next is we have to take a look and see how much metal we're going to need. I have a feeling it's going to be way more than I'm ready to process in a day. It's going to take a long time is all I'm going to say. So let's go ahead and pop over here real quick and just see how much metal it is that we're going to need. It might still be like effective to keep an Anki around. I don't know. It's just that it's so slow. Like the metal's so heavy and it's just so slow. I don't know what the best way to gather it all up is going to be in this area. I think by hand really is going to be the best way to do it. But inside of here, let's go ahead and take a look. Industrial Forge 2,500 metal ingots. That's a lot of metal ingots, man. All right, so first things first, I think we're just going to have to start gathering. Oh, man, we got all sorts of bad hombres around here. I think we're just going to have to start gathering up a little bit more building materials. We need some wood. We should probably, instead of using wood to... power the refining forges, or the refining forge, we should probably just go ahead and use spark powder, so we're gonna have to make some of that too. But we have a lot of metal gathering to do here. I don't even know if we can do this in a day. Like, it's gonna take a long time. It's gonna be a lot of this, peeps. Oh, can we harvest this? No. So we're gonna be doing a lot of this, peeps. I almost feel like I want to bring out Fat Bug or, I don't know, maybe the golem, just to have. And then maybe we do need a ramp. I think we might have to take this to the next level. And we're back, and let me see, what time is it? I think a storm's coming in. I got a little storm indicator for my Jerboa buddy, but then, like, nothing happened, and it got really dark. I don't know if... It sounds like there's a storm. It's really weird. It might be an electrical storm. So I'm not really sure what's going on. We're just grabbing the last little bit of oil that we're going to need. We're on our way to our industrial stuff and things. But as you can see over here, let me go ahead and fill up. Let me see where we're at here. So I got a little bit of metal from back at my base. I got some stuff and things from back at the base. Let's go ahead and take a look. The industrial stuff and things, where we're at. All right, we have the oil. We don't have enough polymer. We can go out into the desert and get that from mantises. Manti. We're halfway done with the cementing paste. We don't have any crystal yet. And we have only 500 of the metal that we need. So let me take a look. I've got some cementing paste crafting in here. So there's another 300 right there. So that should be enough. Let's take a look at how it's going with the metal stitch. What kind of metal? What kind of metal stuff and things we got going on here? And it's super hot over here, man. I've been getting like super bad heat stroke. Oh, I can't move. Crap, damn. All right, let's go ahead and drop that guy like so. So this isn't even close. Like, you need so much metal to craft this thing. It's absolutely ridiculous. I have 6 refining forges here, and I'm pretty sure in order to do this in a timely fashion, I'm gonna need like to double that at least. So, all right, 757. We're not even halfway there on metal. The crystal I can go and get. We're done on cementing paste and organic polymer. To be honest with you, we're pretty close to done over here. Over in this area right here, I brought Grignac over so we can gather up some stuff and things, and I built this little ramp deal for him. So when you come, when you're out gathering stuff and things, and you've like gathered up some stuff, one of the right. You've gathered up some stuff and things like so. You can just bring him over to this ramp like this. and you can just go ahead and hop off, and then you can just walk onto the ramp and bring all your stuff and things up into the base area, the little industrial thingy-doodle that we got here. But the problem that I'm finding is that, and really, I'm super disappointed about this, but stone elementals, they don't harvest metal. They just get, like, it's like a dodic. They just get stone from it. So I've got a bunch of different stuff and things in here too. But yeah, so I'm really kind of super sad about that. I was like, you know what would be so cool is if these guys were like a workhorse that gathered metal up. And I don't know why we haven't seen more of that with like how the beaver has the bonus to, you know, weight. The wooden weight on a beaver is super, super low. I was kind of like hoping because there were so many like secret updates that came out, stuff and things that were released in Scorched Earth that we didn't know about. And I was like, oh man, wouldn't it be cool if the rock elementals were like really good at gathering metal and they got like a bonus for it and it weighed less for them, but it doesn't. You can't even gather it at all on them, which is a bummer. But yeah, so, and I don't want to build, I was thinking about building that ramp like we were talking about, a ramp where like you could bring an Anki over here or a Mantis or something like that. And I really don't want to because that would allow hostile creatures to get up here and I could build the gate and do all that stuff. But I don't know. I feel like it was just a missed opportunity with the rock elemental for being able to gather up metal stuff and things. But we'll still just gather it up. When we're gathering it up by hand, honestly, we get a huge amount of it. The other thing that I think we're going to need over here is we are going to need some sort of a little adobe house structure because when, like, storms come or when you're working out here, like, it gets super duper hot. I don't think we want to necessarily connect it to this. We might want to put it, like, down over here or something like that, just in a different little area, a little house deal. Like, right here would be probably cool. Just a little small house deal so that you can come in and get rid of heat stroke or something like that. So I'm probably going to work on building that next. But we need a lot more metal, guys. We need more refining for it, just to be honest with you. I think I actually have a few more that I've built. Oh, crap. I thought I had, like, four more somewhere. Are they on Tesla? What do we got here? Oh, we got some more of these bad boys, but that's it. No, nothing. All right, so I think we need a little bit of a house. We need a little bit of more refining forges, but stuff and things are happening. It's coming along. One quarters of the way there. And we're back with, I just took a break. I loaded up the industrial refining forges, pardon me, and took a break and played a couple games of Overwatch and came back. And I'm wondering if we're close to having enough metal. I'm hoping that we are. I really actually don't think we are. I think we're like 75% the way there. And I was trying to make, you know what? I wanted to make this industrial forge today because I really need this. Like, I really think it'd be cool for the community to have it. We don't need a ton of metal in Scorched Earth, but we need some. And then I was like, oh yeah, it'll be cool. Like, I'll make it fun. And I was like, I don't think I can make this super fun. Like, it's fun. It's kind of fun, but it's not super fun. It's not as fun as killing a baby Jaboa that just got born accidentally killing it. I feel so bad still about little buddy 7. But it looks like I was right. We are, well, a little more than halfway there. Let's take a look inside of here again one more time. We're at 2,000, so we need 500 more metal. That means that we are 4/5 the way there. The everything else we're good to go, and the polymer we're just going to get from mantises and all that, like I said before. But we still have more stuff and things to do. So, oh, I have the little house built. I don't think I showed you this. I just built a little shack over here. It's nothing major. There's nothing really in it. And I just put a bed in there just in case somebody wanted to spawn over here. And I renamed the bed Community Forge Bed. So it's ready to rock and roll. There's a little teeny house over here too, as well as this little refining forge area and this little area here. I don't think I'm actually going to need this very much. And I'll probably end up bringing Grignac back to base because since he doesn't gather metal, it doesn't really have a use out here. And once the industrial forge is up, like, we'll just leave it here and it'll just sit. So maybe we do need to, I mean, I just don't see it. Like, all the little metal nodes are so far away, it just doesn't make any sense to use a dino to try to harvest them. Even if you had, you know what I mean? Like, it doesn't make sense to me to, like, take an Anki and grab him on your wyvern because you're gonna have to, like, do a big loop and then it's gonna suck because your big loop is gonna, then you'll have to miss it and then you'll go again. And then by the time you did all that, you could have just flown out and done it by hand and it would have been a lot faster. So, speaking of, that means we have a little bit of water. We're running a little bit low on food. I'm probably going to have to head back to base. Or actually, I could probably just build a couple campfires over here and kill this Paraceratherium and get some stuff and things. But, so, looks like more metal. Look at this. There we go. More metal gathering and a little bit more, a little couple more games of Overwatch, and then we should be good to go here. And we're back, finally. Oh, my goodness gracious. All right, so let's take the organic polymer out of here and then transfer all items except nail today's decay. It can't be stopped. This should be everything that we need now. Oh, wait. except gasoline. Crap. Wait, I know I have some, don't I? Yeah, I do. I have gas. I have gas right here. We'll go ahead and split this up. We'll leave 20 gas in here and 20 gas in there. So, all right. So we'll squirt that into here like so. Let's go ahead and turn this bad boy on. And then industrial forge stuff and things are happening. Oh my God, damn, this scoops up. How much heat stroke do I have? Only 3%. Not doing too bad. All right, so there it is. All right, sweet. Turn this bad boy off. Holy moly, I forget. I always forget how big this stupid thing is. It's so big, man, it's crazy. Let's go ahead and go like so. And then we want it right on the center line here. We can't really see if it's poking through. Oh, we can. Oh my gosh, I always forget. This thing is so stupidly big, man. All right, there it is. Oh yeah, baby. Industrial forge stuff and things are happening. Woohoo! All right, so we're good to go with it. Let's go ahead and pull most of the gas out of here. We'll squirt some inside of here. We have all the stuff and things here to make more gas if we need it. And that's it, ladies and gentle peeps. We have done it. It is an amazing thing that we have done. We have done this amazing thing. And that is craft the industrial forge. I want to put this away if that's okay with you. I want to take a big old screenshot. Big old screenshot of our industrial area here. Something like this. Yeah, not looking too bad. Pretty cool. So, that being said, and that being done, that's good. We're good. We're good to go. We got stuff and things that we can make metal, and that's it. That's all we needed. So, we're good to go with this project. Moving on. Now, if I'm not mistaken, and I might be, I heard that the Archaeopteryx has been added to Scorched Earth. So, me and Maz did a little bit of a spotlight on them. I actually haven't tamed one in the wild yet. I'm not sure where it is that they're spawning on Scorched Earth. Or I haven't even seen one. I know the tape jars are spawning here. I saw one the other day. But the Archaeopteryx, I'm not sure where they are. If I had to guess, I would guess they're down in the riverbed areas. But I haven't seen any near or around my base. But I think it'd be cool to tame up. So probably going to need to go and get... you know what? I don't think I have any Bola on me. So we're probably going to have to go grab a couple Bola. Figure out what it is that they're going to eat. I'm sure that it is primitive mantis saddle. Okay. So, I already have a ramshackle one of those bad boys, so we don't need a primitive one. But yeah, figure out all the stuff and things that we need to get the Archaeopteryx going, and see if we can't go and find one and get it tamed up. And we're back. And this place is crazy, man. I just came... This is so weird. I flew over here. There's just this massive battle going on. Morellotops and just... There's a huge amount of dinos in this area. It was really weird, too. It was like they were all in a ball. Look how many are here. Where the crap are we? That is so weird. This reminds me of, like, Bronto Alley on the island map. Like, what is up with the dinos that are here? There are so many. That is so super strange, man. Look at them all. I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9... 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I count 18 Morellotops right in this one little area. What is this? There's somebody's base over here? Somebody's little teeny weeny base? Is that... Did I see a base? Yeah, I see a little teeny weeny base. I don't know what's going on, though. That's so strange that there's, like, all these Morellotops over in this area. That's just super weird to me. So, I've kind of did a little bit of research on the Archaeopteryx. I forgot they eat chitin. So the eat chitin, which is weird, it kind of goes along with the whole, like, the rock elementals eat rocks. You know, they don't eat regular food. And then these guys, the Archaeopteryx, are going to eat chitin. And if I'm not mistaken, I think they're attracted to, like, certain kinds of trees in this. Or I don't know what it is exactly. These trees over here and a couple of the things that I was looking at, it seemed to be that they were, like, in and amongst these little areas where these little trees were. So I'm not really sure. I'm not seeing any right now. But I still have to find, like, some chitin anyway. And I'm thinking I can get it from a water bug. But if I kill this guy, I think he's gonna... His ragdoll's broken. Oh, no, there's five. All right, so do they fix the ragdoll on those guys? That's a little bit wacky. That's probably enough as long as we find a low-level one for us to be able to go ahead and get it tamed up. Now, like I was saying, I've got to kind of find one first, though. And taking a look around... I thought that this is where they were. But I'm not seeing any. So, all right. So we know they got chitin. We got bolas. We got darts. We got all the stuff and things that we need in order to tame one up now. Now all we have to do is kind of try to figure out where it is that they're spawning. And I'll do a little bit of research so I can tell you. I'm kind of inclined just to, like, search around for them and see what I can find. But at the same time, I kind of want to make sure that you guys know what's going on. What the crap is going on here? What the crap is going on here, Chicken Bone? Chicken Bone's base is... Oh, wait. Is that Chicken Bone? Oh, I don't think it is. I don't know exactly whose base that is. Hold on a second here. It is Chicken Bone. Wait, is this... Wait, but this is Chicken Bone's base too, right? Oh, this is Blood Eagle. Okay, so... I'm going to do a little bit of research, find out exactly where they spawn. Look at all these guys. They got a little, whole little community going over here. Yeah, any hizzle. And I will be our bees, peeps.
And we're back.
And I have been walking around Joshua Trees. Elba Fudd here. I've been walking around Joshua Trees for about an hour. Wait, is that the guy from Big Bang Theory? And I gotta tell you, man, it looks to me like they've... Oh, there's one right there! I can't even believe it. It looks to me like they've made these, like, as difficult to find as... Like, they're so unbelievably difficult, and they're so unbelievably useless that I can't imagine it. Like, an hour and a half of searching to find something that's about as useful as a dodo. So let's see if we can tame this guy here. Oh, I missed. Okay. All right, I got this. I got this time. Oh, no, this time. Okay, I got this time. You ready? Oh, what? What the frig? Oh, he... Wow. These, like... Where the frig fracture to go? Okay, let me see if I can just hit him. Okay, that didn't work. Let's see if I can just hit him again. Do they land ever? Where did he go? He's, like, invisible. With a... He, like, gets spooked or something. Okay, is there any bad ombres around here? I saw a terror bird. I'm a little bit afraid. I think maybe... Is he over here? I think maybe if I get over here, eventually it lands. And when it lands, I'm going to try to bean it. And I'm hoping... Oh, what level are you, homie? Watch it be like 120. I can't even see what level it is. It's a 16 Arca? I think it's a 16. I can't even see. All right, let me see here. Nope. Oh, it looks like I got the animation of a hit. Well, here it goes. Where'd it go? Oh, this land for more than an instant. Wait, this is crazy difficult. Just get some, stupid. Yes, I did it. Taste that can't be stopped. The simplest thing of all. And I can't access this inventory because all the stuff is around it. And I don't want to hit it because it is super low level. Can I, like, go like this? Can we get in here now? Is it? Oh, we're getting in trouble. We're in deep trouble. Oh, no. Ah! Get some. Okay. Now, where the frig was that thing? Okay, it's over here. We're really, really trying. Did I bring my chitin keratin with me? And my chitin is right there. We're really trying. Is it dead? It's unconscious. But I can't access the friggin' inventory. And I don't want to kill myself or kill this stuff. Can I... like this? I can't even harvest this stuff. Okay, there we go. Maybe now. Is it going to break? Break. Okay. Oh, is its topor going down? Okay. Oh my gosh, what a huge pain in the butt! Okay, we're almost there. I feel like we're almost at the point where we can access this inventory. I cannot access this thing's... Wait, come here. What the frig is wrong with it, man? Oh, man! And we're back! I had to shoot it with another trank dart, and so it's taming effective is going to be garbage, but I couldn't access this inventory, and so I cut the tree down and then harvested everything around it, and then I was able to access this inventory. So it should probably tame up like in an instant, I'm guessing. There is an eat. There's an eat. And there's an eat. Oh my gosh. We'll name this guy PETA. Pain in the butt. All right. So there we go. And we got it. Let's take a look at it. Let's see how amazing it is. It is pretty cool looking. I will not lie. And then I don't know if you guys saw. Not everybody watches everything. So I don't know if you guys saw the spotlight. But you look ridiculous when you're holding one of these. I had said, you know what would be really cool? I think it would be really, really cool if when you held them, instead of holding them like this. Oh, we're floating, man. We're super floating right now. Oh, yeah. So what I was saying is instead of that, where'd he go? Come over here, man. Is that if it just like went on your shoulder like this and then you could toggle it from like shoulder mode to floaty mode would be way better than the way we've got it now. And actually, don't know how the crap are we going to get it back? How are we going to get back to our base? Oh, we can probably grab it. Yeah, that's it. We'll probably grab it. If we can see it. There it is right there. Okay. Okay, hold on. Huh. Okay, no, we didn't get it. Okay, we got to make a ridiculously long turn around. There's no way I'm going to be able to pick the damn thing up. There's no way. It's not going to be possible. Let me see here. Are you following me still? What are you doing, man? What are you doing? It's following Slipgator, but it's just kind of randomly walking around. All right, so what I'll probably end up doing is bringing it over here. And then out in the open here. There it goes. Look at it run, man. That's super cool. We'll leave it like right here. That way I can get a bead on where it is with Tesla and see if we can pick it up. I'm sure we can pick it up. Then we got to take it somewhere. I don't know. I guess we'll take it back to place and play around with it a little bit. Let me see if we can get a pickup over here. Here we go. Here we go. Here's our try. We did it. Nailed it. It can't be stopped. And we're back. And this is ridiculous. I can't believe how ridiculous this thing is, man. Like, it's super funny. Like, it's just super interesting and funny. You know, and I was just testing out, playing with it a little bit. You can't climb ladders, which makes sense. I mean, obviously, you have both hands on the Archaeopteryx legs. So why would you be able to climb ladders? But, you know, you can't use weapons or tools or anything. Like, it's just, like, such a neat thing. But so not user-friendly. It's just not user-friendly. It's just not something that you could really use realistically in the game ever. Like, but I'm assuming that some of their eggs might be needed, and I don't exactly know off the top of my head what Archaeopteryx eggs are used for, but I'm sure they're used for something. And so it's good that we've started off at least to get one, and then to be honest with you, I didn't even look. Are you a lady Archaeopteryx or a dude? It's a dude Archaeopteryx, and it's got a cool color on it. They're actually quite interesting looking if you take a look. Like, their little amazing tails are super amazing and cool and very fluffy and awesome. They're very, very interesting. But because they don't really shoulder ride, like, it's just going to be so hard to use them besides, like, for this. Like, just if you were to just want to play around with them, which is super fun. We can just fly around, and that's neat. But yeah, I don't see beyond an Archaeopteryx farm. How you could actually use these, because you can't use tools with them, you can't climb ladders with them, you can't do a lot of things with them, and so yeah, I don't know. I gotta check out on the wiki and see what it is that we use for eggs, but they're super easy to tame up. It's just that you have to find the friggin' guys. Like, they're so hard to find, and then once you get one, like when you're doing this, it's kind of hard to get a landing going on too. Let's see here. What if we? Oh, that hurt. Where did the guy go? Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Where did he go? PETA! Do you guys see a PETA anywhere? No? Where the frig did it go? There it is! Alright, we found it! There's a ladder here. There it is. Sweet. So, alright guys, I gotta tell you what. A little bit, I feel like, I don't know, for some reason I feel like today is a little bit of a fail. We got some stuff and things done. We did the industrial grill, and we got an Archaeopteryx. We accomplished stuff and things today, but I don't know what it is about it, but I think it's because, like, the industrial, like, I don't know. I don't know why. I just feel like it was a bit of a fail day, but I don't know. It's fine. We got a new guy. We did a super cool thing. And I had fun. I did have some fun hanging out with you guys. I hope that you did too. Make sure today, if you liked the video, please don't forget to show your support and hit the like button. I want to pick you up. I don't want to access your inventory. Oh, it's glitched. Feel free to share favorite the videos you see fit. And may the stuff and things be with you.